Hallelujah. I am so happy to be here tonight, amen. I am so happy to be here tonight. I am thankful to my pastor and Apostle Michael Hart, as well as our co-pastor, First Lady Akilah Hart, for the opportunity to speak here tonight, amen. It is a joy and an honor to bring the Word of God. It's a joy to be used by the Lord, amen. And to be able to speak to his people, and I do not take it lightly, amen. Hallelujah. So without further ado, we're going to go ahead and jump right into the Word tonight. Amen. Amen. We're going to go ahead and jump right into the Word. Now, last time I spoke, I didn't realize it. I told y'all about me. So I after watching the videotape, I was speaking for quite a long time. But I promise you I won't do that to you tonight. Amen. I told you when a preacher hasn't spoke for a while, he can get a lot of things on his mind. Amen. But I promise you we won't hold you long tonight because God has a word prepared for you, amen? And I did a lot of soul searching and a lot of preparing so I can hear and be clear about what God wanted to tell you on this night, amen? And I mean, as you know, our theme for the year is God is fulfilling his dream in 2013, amen? He's fulfilling your dream, your destiny, the things that you have. But I want to remind you and let you know that the only person that can kill that for you, no devil in hell can stop that. Only you can get in the way of what God has planned for you. Amen?
Amen.
But I want you to know today that we are going to talk about the icing on the cake. Amen? We're going to talk about the icing on the cake. Not only are we going to fulfill the dream, but we're going to get everything that God has to offer us. Amen? Not only are we going to sit down and have desserts, I want my cake and eat it too. I'm going to tell you the truth about it. But I want icing on my cake, amen? I want sprinkles, amen? I want everything that God has to offer me, and I'm not going to leave nothing lingering, amen? So that means we got to be prepared for what God has for us. Would you stand with me for just a moment, amen? And we're going to go to the book of John. While you're standing, the book of John chapter 10, at verse number 10. Book of John, chapter 10, and verse number 10. And God has been, you know what the Lord is working on you, because this has kind of been in my spirit for a while. Even in those of you that are in choir, and you heard me speak about this the other day, it's like, you know, God has a plan. He has something prepared. And he's been putting us through some different things, amen? And I know for some of you, everything didn't change at the turn of the clock from 2012 to 13, amen? There's still some things you've got to straighten out and iron out and go through, amen? But it's coming.
Yeah.
Amen. It's coming. It's on the way. Don't get faint. Don't get weary. Amen. And don't lose faith. Amen. Trust and believe that God is going to do everything he said
Amen.
He was going to do for you. He showed it to you. He showed it to you. And we've been talked about to, and the pastors prophesied to you. And others have spoken these things in your life. And you know and felt it because you felt it for a long time. But now is the time to receive it. Amen. Amen. The book of John, chapter 10, and verse number 10, it says that the thief does not come except to kill, steal, and destroy. I have come that they might have life and have it more abundantly. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your word, Lord God. We thank you for your guidance and instruction, Heavenly Father. We thank you, Lord God, because we know we can trust in your word, Father God. We know when we're walking straight and upright in your word, Father God, that nothing can harm us or be in our way, Father. So we ask, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, Lord God, that you will make the pathway straight for us tonight, Lord God. If there are things that are hindering us in our minds, Lord God, we ask that you will wipe away those cares, those concerns, those bills, those kids, whatever it is that is on our minds right now, those people that made us angry, Lord God, and allow us to receive what you have planned for us tonight, Lord. Lord God, we thank you. And I, as a preacher, Lord God, ask that in the name of Jesus, Father God, that you would take over, Lord God. If there's anything that I prepare for you, Lord God, remove it, Lord God, and replace it with what you would have me tell your people here tonight, Father God. Lord God, I love you, and I thank you, and I praise you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen, 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 amen. Hallelujah. The icing on the cake, amen. The icing on the cake, amen, amen, amen. It's hard today in this world to kind of see and reach for the great things in God. And I'm going to tell you why, and I'll be honest with you, because this world we live in is so filthy and corrupt. It's so horrible, the things that we see daily, that it's hard. Amen? it's hard to receive everything because there's so many people, even in your lives and in your own family, those that can be used to ruin your steps and your walk and your direction, amen? There's so many different things going on in this world. We take it for granted sometimes, the love and the path that God has laid out for us and the things that he's given us. Sometimes we don't see it the way we should, amen? When we talk about things that are going on in this world and the problems that we have with walking in the path that God has given us, see, we have to worry about the devil worshipers, amen? We accept these things in life. And when I say we accept it, yeah, you don't go out and you don't hang with the devil worshipers and all this, but your kids are, and you're listening to the music, amen? Hallelujah. The singers and rappers are out there giving their souls away to the devil. And it's one thing that always bothered me about that. It's one thing that always caught my spirit as a man of God and someone knowing God is if you can believe there's a devil.
Come on.
If you can believe there's a devil, why can't you trust in the one who created you? Amen? If you can give your soul to the enemy, why can't you believe and understand that there is a God? And see, these people jump around, I'm no Christian, I don't believe, but when the rapper says, I gave my soul to the devil, and they rocking with it. See, it's so easy to believe the things of the enemy. It's so easy to believe the things of the world and the things that are going on around us. Why can't we see the other side of the coin? Amen? Because it's so tainted. Because fame and fortune has these people piped into our homes. Yeah, I don't allow my kids to listen to all of this stuff, but then I turn around and they got it on their iPod. And you try to give them something nice and before you know it, on their computer is full with Rihanna and Jay-Z and Kanye West and all these others out there who are living the life. They go to school and they're influenced by this, amen? I'll tell you the truth about it. I went the other morning, I got up early and I couldn't sleep, and I went in the living room and I was watching TV, and I turned in TV, I said, let me see what's going on out here in the world. Now, y'all know me, you know that I was a DJ for many years, so music is not foreign to me, amen? But I wanted to see what these kids were listening to and doing. And as soon as I turned on my TV, there was some song about a cat worshiping, basically worshiping strippers. And I'm like, man, I didn't even get it good on the channel yet. And already. And I know that if it's on the TV, I know that it's on the radio, because I don't want to hear that stuff, amen? But see, I had to do this because when our kids are going out there, and these are the things we're fighting against sometimes, amen? Sometimes you need to be able, and I'm not telling you, this ain't for everybody, okay? So you can't walk in my steps, I'm going to tell you the truth. You know, God has ordained you to do certain things, amen? He's ordained me to do, he's shown me certain things. So sometimes I have to look with the mind's eye and be able to see what's going on around me because I need to know what to be praying about. I need to know what to focus on when I'm dealing with my family, my children. Amen. So I'm not telling you to go turn to this stuff and see what's happening, but I'm just trying to give you a picture of what's accepted now. It's cool to be a pole dancer now. Amen. It's cool. All homosexuality is all good now. Amen? When TV first came out, Ricky and Lucy didn't even sleep in the same bed. Amen? They didn't even sleep in the same bed. Now we got to see everything that's going on in the bed on the show. We don't need to see that. Do we need to know? But see, it's acceptable now. And not only men and women, but women and women. Men and men. They got all these different type of family things put together now. It's all acceptable in how we live. So when I say it's hard to walk as a Christian, brother or sister in this world, and get everything that God has to offer, well, you've got to meander your way through all of this mess. Drugs and alcohol, it's all good. I'm gonna put some of y'all on First Street, and if you stuck watching them reality shows, amen. I want you to watch. stops when all the drama goes down. The drama doesn't go down when everybody's kicking and relaxing. The drama goes down when they go to the club or they're at the house with a bunch of drinks. Are you paying attention to that? Drugs and alcohol are acceptable in our community. It's no big thing no more, amen? You get caught selling drugs, it's all good. But he's just making the way, he's just trying to feed his family, he's just trying to do what he gotta do. Amen? Can I get a witness in here? Am I stepping on some toes? I got heavy feet.
Step on them.
Amen? So I hope I'm cutting you a little bit, amen? Because we're going to talk about it today because we need to understand and start seeing because we accept this stuff. We accept it like it's all good, like it's okay. And then when I put up my fist to it and say, that's not going down around here, I'm looking at it as being, you're doing too much, Ray. It's not that serious. But it is that serious. If you heard me preaching on the beginning of our album, I said that the gap between what God is expecting us to do, amen, and I put it on the right hand, amen, what God wants us to do and how he wants to live and the way the world is living, that gap is further or far from now.
Yes.
See, remember when Lucy and them, they didn't share a bed, the gap was a little bit closer, amen, but the gap is getting further and further and further apart. We don't have time to be trying to play around and go hang out with people. I don't have time to go back to the club. I said it before, that spirit is waiting for me to come back there. But I've been removed. Amen? You've been removed from those things. So I'm not going to talk bad about those that are doing it because I don't know who God got an eye on. I don't know whose name is written down in the Lamb's Book of Life. My job is to talk about Jesus. Amen. To tell you about another way. And to show you. See, God has he has foretold all of these things. Amen? He's foretold all of this in his word. So I can speak that into you and it has to touch you. It has to because you were created by him. Whether you believe it or want to fall or want to go or not. You got to feel it. Now, whether you accept it, that's on you.
Yeah.
Amen?
Yeah.
Deceit and lies nowadays. People are praised for the ability to go around and say, oh, I got over on homie. I got him.